If you 3D print, at some point you're gonna have to dry your filaments. Today's the day I picked up the Creality Space Pi filament dryer. The dryer comes in a well-protected packaging and surprising amount of plastic wrapping. On first impression, this thing is smaller than I expected, which is good because compact is always good, as long as it fits whatever I need to dry. Stored inside the dryer, we have a power cable, a PTFE tube for feeding your filament while drying, and a user manual. I definitely like the look of it so far, especially with this smoky transparent cover. But even with all that plastic wrapping, mine came with some scratches. And weird stains I could not remove. Not exactly the best first impression. Looking at the dryer itself, I thought the cover might be flimsy, but they actually feel pretty good in hand. The hinge does not wobble around and the cover is thick enough to feel solid. This is slightly above my expectation. To power on the machine, I first have to plug in the cable. A power button lights up on the display. That shows me where to press and gives me a nice boot up animation. Before purchasing, I've read that this display isn't very responsive, and I do agree with that to some extent. It does miss my input sometimes, but since I won't be pressing on it very often anyway, it's not too bad. Now putting all that aside, let's see how well it dries. This TPU has been sitting out for weeks. It's definitely wet and I couldn't print anything proper out of it. So taking a quick check before putting it in the dryer, it weighs 581 grams, which makes sense because it's a smaller half kilo spool and it fits quite well in the dryer still, not moving around or anything. So this dryer has a top opening for ventilation purpose. It also has another opening here to feed filament out while it's drying. I've read that sometimes the PTFE tube can slip out and cause a jam if this coupler isn't installed. But I'm not sure if I like this solution very much, as installing the coupler is rather tricky. Since I'm just testing the drying capabilities, I'll come back to this later in the video. I've set the dryers to 50 Celsius for 6 hours. Hot air is coming out from the back, so checking how noisy it gets, it's about 50 to 51 decibels with the cover open. With the cover closed, it's a few decibels lower, and in person that's a noticeable difference. But now it's time to wait. At some point, I've bumped up the temperature to 55 Celsius, which the humidity meter also responded accordingly. So I suppose the sensors here are working as intended. After 6 hours of drying, it's about 1.5 grams lighter than before. According to ChatGPT, that's a pretty good result for half a kilo spool. I don't have anything to print in TPU right now, so I'll swap over to this ABS spool, which also needs drying. Judging from this temperature test print, the stringing is pretty bad, even at the lowest temperature. I am seeing zits on the surface, which is all pointing to signs of wet filament. Before drying, it weighs about 1,147 grams. So I'll put it in for 6 hours at 70 Celsius. After 2 hours, I wanted to see how it's doing, so I took it out and measured again. And it's now 1 gram lighter than before. Seems like it's drying faster than the TPU spool. So I put it back into the dryer for the full 6 hours. And it now weighs 1,142 grams. That's 5 grams lighter in just 6 hours. The next step here is to do another test print, which came out looking a lot better. Less stringing and less zits on the surface, at least when compared to before. But I do think it's still slightly wet, so I'll put it back into the dryer overnight. I forgot to weigh it before and after this time, but I did print a third temperature test for comparison. The improvements were not as significant, but it still seems to have improved. I'm not sure if drying any further would give me any better results. So putting the newly dried ABS filament to the test, let's print something to fix the PTFE tube coupler issue earlier. I printed this lever mod by Dedge, which is supposed to solve four problems at once. I'll link his mod in the description if you want to try it out as well. The print came out nice. I printed directly from the dryer, and there are still some zits on the surface. But until I troubleshoot other factors, I wouldn't say the filament is still wet just yet. For now, let's assemble them onto the dryer. The assembly actually asked for a single piece of filament bent into this two hole, but mine keep breaking in half, so I'll be using two pieces instead. Once that's done, the printed part holds the PTFE tube in place quite well. I'd say slightly better than stock, but if you need more grip, there's always the M10 connector version. I really like that it also locks the cover shut. I can now grip onto the dryer by the cover without it swinging open, which is annoying sometimes. You can sort of see that when I was trying to unbox it earlier. This mod also allows more moisture to escape while drying by holding the cover open in this position, should you choose to do so. Now, that's an interesting topic because now we're talking about increasing the drying effectiveness. I've also seen mods that store desiccant inside the dryer to help remove moisture faster, but I'm not sure how much these mods would help. And I feel like that's a topic for another video, which I should follow up on soon. What do you think of this dryer? Would you get one? If you have enjoyed this so far, consider subscribing for that follow-up video, and I'll see you in the next one.